Hey everyone, happy Sunday to you. I thought I'd just drop in to share a little quick video on my trip to Angela's Happy Stamper in Reston, Virginia. It's located just outside of Washington, D.C., and it's fairly close to where I live, so I have the benefits of going there every now and then. I try not to go too much because they have a wide variety of stamps, but when I find myself looking for something specific that I like and don't have time to research or order online, I prefer to go to Angela's Happy Stamper because they have a great selection and I pretty much can find what I need there every time I go and looking for something special and on a time crunch. So I went there to look for a charcoal barbecue grill stamp, and you'll know why it's in tomorrow's card, and you're also getting a hint for what I'm going to do for tomorrow's card. But I went looking for Hero Arts. I forget the name of their set. I'm so sorry, but it's a Father's Day card with a barbecue grill set. And they didn't have it, but they did have other barbecue grill sets, stamps, I should say. So I did get that, and I'll show that to you later. And I also picked up some other things. So first I want to show you is Hero Arts pack of note cards with the matching envelopes, the craft ones. It comes with a set of 8. Their price was $4.50 there. And here is one. Christina Werner, as you probably have seen before, she uses these often on her cards. And I just wanted to see for myself and get an idea of what, you know, type of quality it was. And it's a lighter quality than what I'm used to stamping and using for my card bases. It's kind of flimsy. It's very light. So it's not something that I probably plan to use in the future. No offense to Hero Arts. I love them and I love their stamps, but it's just not what I personally like to use. I like to use a heavier weight cardstock. This one's paper tray ink. This is just a sample. The color is different. It's a lot lighter than Hero Arts color. So I do prefer Hero Arts color over paper tray inks, but I love paper tray ink's quality and the weight of the cardstock a little bit better than Hero Arts. So I'm probably going to just use them and get them a little bit more. Just so you can get an idea, this is a card I make out of paper tray inks. I don't know why I can't hold this straight on the camera, but anyway, craft cardstock a couple weeks ago. There's the inside. I never showed a picture of it, but just so you can get an idea, the weight, it's not as flimsy. This might be a little bit annoying, but this one is just, it wobbles a little bit more than this. It's just heavier. I think paper tray, again, uses 110 pound weight. And I'm not sure what Hero Arts is or if it says it on here. Maybe I should read it. No, it doesn't say it. But what it does say is it's used out of 100% recycled paper. And so that's a great thing because it's very eco-friendly. And I commend Hero Arts on that. So next what I got was these 7 Gypsies Notting Hill clear stamps. It just spoke to me. I really like the design of them. So I had to pick them up. What I liked best was this stamp right here because you can put the sentiment in the middle, and I love the scroll flourish design around it that, of course, I'm probably going to cut out. I also like this textile stamp. It reminds me of paper tray inks, which I don't have yet, but I like theirs. Also, this flourish here, butterfly and the bird. They are just great, great additions. I probably have something similar already, but I liked it, and I'm sort of an impulsive buyer, especially when it comes to stamps. Technique Tuesday. I like their stamp sets a lot. This one's called Loopy Labels. I'm probably going to use it quite often. It's a sentiment-based stamp. You can also use it for other things. I'm sure you can stamp like designs inside of the scallop here. So I'm probably going to cut these out and use them for sentiments. What I really liked was this stamp here where there's a line where you can stamp a sentiment between the two lines. But you can probably just stamp or ink one side of the one end of the stamp there and get a line underneath of your sentiment, or just draw a line with the ruler. But I just really thought that was a neat stamp set. The other Technique Tuesday stamp set that I got was called Back to School. I don't have any school related stamps, and probably that's because I don't have any kids. But sometimes I get requests from people. They want thank you notes and things like that, and they like a theme that deals with school. And so I thought this was a great addition to my stamp collection. I'll probably keep it probably forever. The stamp set is not only good for back to school. You can also use it for graduation. As you can see here, there is a diploma and there's a cap. The ruler can be used for a lot of different things as well, even for a masculine car. Think about if your husband or a significant other likes to measure things or something like that. You can put that on there, something with a sentiment like you're immeasurable or something. I don't know. The apple could be used for something, some other things. Even the note, even this piece of paper can be used for other things. And of course, the star. So it's not something that I have to only use for back in school, but overall, that's the reason why I picked it up. And as you can see, it was $17 there at Angela's Happy Stamper. And the last thing I got there, well, not the last thing, let me show you this first. I got this white Uniball gel Signo pen, and I have one of these already, but I'm running out, and I use it quite often to do, to draw like hand-free, like lines, stitching, and things like that. Freehand, I mean. I said hand-free, I meant to say freehand. But the real reason why I went again, like I said in the beginning, was to get a charcoal grill stamp. And so I did find this one by the Cat's Pajamas, and it's called Smokin' Barbecue. So I really like it. I think it's great for summer, and especially for masculine cards with the barbecue. And so to go with it, I picked up this one, Sentiment, and it's King of the Grill. I think that's neat. I think of that show, King of the Hill, but anyway. So you'll see what I do with these stamps. I'm going to play with them and as soon as I finish this video, and I'll post the card tomorrow for you to see. So on my way home, I had to stop and fill a prescription at Target, and it was about a 20-minute wait. And so what do I do for 20 minutes in Target? Go to the scrapbook aisle. So what did I end up buying? Making Memories Passport Collection. That's what I showed you the last time, right? So I picked up more chipboard sticker letters. These are a little bit different from the last ones. The other ones were canvas. These are just chipboard, and they have like some sort of text writing on them, and I think that'd be really cool to add to my travel book. And then I found the pattern paper to go with it. And it's a large collection of pattern paper, and I probably won't use it all for the scrapbook, probably for some cards too, because they have some great designs in here. And what it is, you get 24 sheets of double-sided 12 by 12 paper, 6 patterns, 4 sheets of each, and it's cardstock weight, acid and linen free. And so it's just a good multi-pack in there. I think it was like $14 or something like that at Target. So not sure if you're interested in that, but just thought I'd let you know and share with you what I did on my scrapbooking paper crafting purchasing ventures today. So make sure you stop by tomorrow to see my card that will be using this grill stamp, both the grill and the sentiment stamps. Whoops, wrong way. And how I use them. So I have some ideas going in my head, but sometimes they kind of just form as I'm doing my card, so I'm interested to see how it turns out as well. So thanks for stopping by today to see me. I appreciate it, and I hope to see you soon in a new video. Maybe Wednesday. I don't know. I just hope I can do it soon. All right. See you later. Bye.